More of an unstable boy, I'd say, said Waxley, but yes, what a corker of a funeral that was, eh? 3 people died and 15 were hospitalised, Jerry. Ah, memories, said Waxley with a nostalgic smile. It's Gladys I feel sorry for, slurred Yaldon. Loses her husband and then some bloody bugger paints a cock and balls on the side wall of a cottage. So I saw, said Vic. 1 foot long it is, I reckon, said Yaldon. It's a disgrace. Must have come as a shock to her. I'll say. They were childhood sweethearts, and Hugh was the only man she ever slept with, said Waxley. She probably doesn't know that they'd come bigger than a Chardonnay carrot. Then Yaldon choked on his beer. Have some respect, Jerry, said Vic. You just buried the man. Ah, he'd have laughed along with us, said Waxley, smiling. He had a rare sense of humour, did Hugh. Knew every dirty joke in the book, and a few more besides. If he'd been at his own funeral, he'd have wet himself. I know I did, and so did old Miss Shelmardine, incidentally. She really needs to see Dr. Myson about that. Anyhow, here's to Hugh. To you, said Yaldon.
The two men clinked their glasses together and looked expectantly at Vic, who lifted the empty glass he was wiping dry in solidarity.
2 more?
He asked.
Ah, go on then, said Waxley, downing the last of his pint. For Hugh. The little sod spray-painted on Barry Chetwynd's shop window too, said Vic, as he pulled their pints. He reckons it's animal rights protesters. Those scruffy Herberts who are always waving placards outside the abattoir. Could be, said Vic. I didn't understand a bloody word of what they wrote, mind. Bloody buggers. How do they expect us to have bacon sandwiches without killing pigs?